Steve, we're getting lots of telegraphing that's coming early, or at least our expectations of what we think.
There's a lot of disparities between the expectations, with the main question surrounding the meeting is just how easy does the Fed get? This will mark the first round of forecasts since the Fed pivoted to its policy of patience and signaled it will end its balance sheet runoff this year. So here are some of the questions. Does the Fed forecast, the SCP that is, or the dot plots, forecast one hike this year or none? Does it stop predicting restrictive funds rates in outlying years, and does it further downgrade the economy? Last time in December went from 2.5 to 2.3% for GDP this year. So the Fed rate outlook from December called for 2/4-point hikes this year and pushing rates above the long run or neutral rate for 2020 and 2021. That is going restrictive. And you can see that the 2.4 is where we are now. The 2.9 had the two hikes in it, actually one more. And then 3.1, 3.1, those are two times above restrictive, going back down to 2.8, which is neutral. That whole apparatus, that whole structure is going to come down, I think, in the forecast we get. Goldman says, despite the elimination of the hiking bias from the FOMC statement, the dots are likely to retain an upward tilt, whereas B of A says the Fed has one more hike left, likely in December. And that's not all. The Fed will likely provide details of its plans to end its balance sheet runoff this year, maintaining it at a larger than expected $3.7 to $3.8 trillion. And there were days, Becky, we talked about $2.5 to $3 trillion on the balance sheet. So just add a trillion, then a couple hundred more billion, and that's where we are these days. And just one more thing, the dot plot, it's unclear what purpose it's serving right now. It's not.
I know what purpose it's serving.
You must applaud
frustrating and
you want to applaud
everywhere.
Transparency. And remember, we used to clamor for this, right? We used to want to know,
well,
what's your outlook? And then we're going to say, the trouble is, if we all together randomly give a number, and that number, provided randomly, becomes a policy statement, that's where the Fed gets in trouble.
It should be like the Olympics, where they throw out the highs and the lows.
That's in there. That's already in there. There is a central tendency there. The problem is the way the market grasps it, right? The market says the average or the median is the policy. And it's not. It's a set of not random, but a set of forecasts put together that become policy.